But over time, you certainly have seen that we changed and moved some things as well. We wanted to show you a glimpse of what is going on behind the scenes today. But where to start? There are so many things that I can show you because, of course, we are working on our business every day and we are producing not only products, but also websites, funnels, lead magnets. We have a podcast, we have a blog, and then we do Instagram, Facebook. So fortunately, we are not doing this alone because not only is it more lonely when you are struggling on your own, but it's also more fun when you can do it with your sibling, of course. I'm really, really grateful that Hilde is my partner in building this business because she's really good at project management. And we have like tons of tools that help us on a daily basis deciding what we need to do, who does what are the details of what needs to be done, and how far can we work ahead, for instance. But the first thing, of course, is knowing where you are going, because if you have a vision, if you have the same values, or you have determined your values, then it's much easier to create your plan to achieve the things that you want to accomplish. But over time, you certainly have seen that we changed and moved some things as well. I can remember the first videos that we recorded were, for me, for instance, in a different setting, because I was downstairs in the office with my husband. He's a professor, so he teaches the whole day, and I'm creating videos like this. So that was really hard. And so we decided that I would move office. In the meantime, I'm really happy with the office that I have here. I have a beautiful site. And I show you, if it's possible, on the park. So lots of trees, lots of greenery. So yeah, that's one of the things that changed. Another thing is that we had a lot of different tools that we worked with. And some of them we are still using, and others we stopped. We changed tools because for us, for a small business, it was more convenient to use the other tools. So know that the decisions that you take as a business owner, they are not carved in stone. I think it's good to change in the beginning because then you you can see what is the best tool for you and what training is the best training for you and what is most suited for the things that you want to do. We have worked with a lot of free tools, a lot of paying tools. And so I think we created a set of tools that we are working with now. And the things that we are doing at the moment is creating our SOPs, or standard operating procedures, because we are, as we said in former videos, we are preparing for a virtual assistant. And if you have your standard operating procedures, that is a bunch of instructions on how to do things so that anybody can come sit at my desk, open the SOP. How do I include a picture in a mail, or how do I set up a funnel, or stuff like that? So we are doing everything ourselves. And some of the things that we did ourselves are going really good. And other things like Facebook advertising, for instance, is far more difficult. But we wanted to learn it because, yeah, of course, we love to learn both. But it's not because you love to learn that you love to do everything that you learn. So there are certain things that I love doing more than Hilde. And there are things that Hilde loves doing more than I, and that she's definitely much better in than I am. So we are dividing sort of our tasks between each other. And then there are tasks that we already marked now, like, I don't really like to do it. I follow the training, but I'm not really sure that I really grasp what is needed. And so these are tasks that we are marked to outsource in the future. There's one tool that we started using from the beginning and that we are still using, and that is Trello. And I'll give you a very short glimpse into our Trello just to show you how it works for us.
As you can see in our Trello, we have a lot of workspaces and we have a lot of Trello boards in each of the workspaces. We do have a free Trello, so this is something you can do for yourself as well. But we have really many, many workspaces and many things that we are gathering and that we are organizing in our Trello. And I think maybe the three most important ones are our products, our funnels, and our marketing workspaces. And the one that is maybe the most visual to show you is how we are doing our funnels. And as you can see, we have funnel development first, funnel integrations, the test stage, and these are our funnels in production. But for instance, in the funnel development, so when I open the funnel development board, you can see that we have several lists. So you see, this is the entry list. So when we have a product that needs to be marketed, then and that is ready, then it comes to the entry list. And on some of these lists, there are checklists that we created. For instance, the funnel development checklist. All kind of stuff that you have to think of when you are creating a funnel. For instance, for this funnel that we are creating, we have to add the checklist, funnel development checklist that we want to add. And voila, you can see everything that we have to do is on the card right now. Let's say that we created the funnel pages, then you can strike it through and even hide. Voila, and you move your card through every list in the board. And then automatically when you see the card disappeared because it went to a new board . It went automatically to funnel integrations. So when we are looking at funnel integrations, might take us a while to get there. Voila, here we are. Then we see that the card that we just showed you in the funnel development is moved to the entry list of our funnel integrations. And what do we mean by funnel integrations? You can add a checklist once again. So this is a checklist of Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, Facebook Pixels, and all kinds of stuff. So again, you move your cart through the lists and you go through every list on the board before you say, okay, this funnel is ready for stage 3, the funnel testing. So when we take a look at the funnel testing, once again, we see our card appearing here, and we once again move it through all the lists. So we have different checklists to add again. We have a funnel testing and a product testing checklist. And once again, we move the cart through all the stages or all the lists of our Trello board. And now at the end, it does stop. We don't have an automatic upload into the funnel production board because that is something that we have to do really consciously. And one thing that is really a good thing that you can do is you can add members. So for instance, if I am the one that is going to do the funnel testing for this particular funnel, then I put my name next to it. And you see, I am the one that is responsible for this. So you can see in one eye glance, when you do it properly and you put your name next to it, you can see the tasks that you have been dealt with.
Of course, we have a lot more products, a lot more tools, and a lot more things that we can show you. But today we wanted to keep it at this. If there's anything specific that you want us to tackle, just put it below in the comments and we will make sure to address it.